Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to take you through the essential working components of the ReconPro application. ReconPro is the go-to invoicing, estimate, and work order solution for automotive reconditioning companies and smart repair companies to make it efficient to get work, get approved, do the actual work itself, and then create an invoice, send it off to accounting as well. The system works on iOS devices and Android devices alike, and we also have a web-based management portal for you guys to log in and or your clients to log in so they can see what's going on. So what I'll do right now is we're just going to kind of run through a base overview demo, and if you guys have any questions, you're more than welcome to reach out to us, and we'd be more than happy to do a one-on-one demonstration with you guys. So what I'm going to do, let's pretend that we need to do an estimate on a vehicle. So I'm going to go to inspections. I am going to start a brand new estimate up. And then the first piece of the puzzle in here is I'm going to go ahead and scan the VIN. Since I am indoors, I'll go ahead and just scan this sheet of barcodes. There we go. And then you'll notice that it went ahead and decoded the year, make, and model for us. We can input the color, license plate, mileage, stock number, etc. as well. We also do have duplicate detection, so we can tell you if work's already previously been done on a particular VIN when either it's been scanned or if it's been typed in. And the services list. So the services are the things that you guys are going to be doing to a vehicle. We support everything under the sun, from wheel repair, paintless dent removal, hail, interior, bumpers, lot washes, detail. Any type of automotive service or repair that you guys would need could be added into the system. Our base template comes with all of the most common ones in there, but if you have something that's a little bit unique, you'd be able to go in, change the pricing, etc. We also support customer-specific pricing, so if I was on a specific client, you'd be able to go in and have the recommended price for that be reflected relative to that customer. So what I'll do right now is I'll just click on Use Car Detail. And from within there, once I've added in that service, if we wanted to add in any notes or flag it as prior damage, we can go ahead and do so. We also fully support the ability to enter in, you know, text-based notes, as well as photo capture capability as well. So you could take as many pictures as you would like and add them directly in, utilizing that notes section right there. Once you've got the car written up, etc., you can go ahead and save it. And now we can go about getting an approval. The approval can happen either on the device by having whoever's going to be approving it sign off. There's multiple different ways that this could be configured. You can have them just approve the full estimate itself. You could have them approve it line by line if you'd like. You can easily view the photos, etc. And that all can happen on the device. In addition to just the device, you can have them approve it via what we call a quick link inside of an email. So essentially, that's an email that we would send to the customer. They'd be able to click on it, see any pictures, etc., any services. They'd be able to click that button, sign off saying that they approve it, and then it unlocks it and sends you a notification inside the application letting you know that it's been approved and it's ready to get worked on. So in this case, I'll just do the on-device approval. And I went ahead and did that for two cars. So what we'll do now is I am going to, if you want, you can easily print this off, edit it. If you made a mistake, you can change the customer, email it, etc. I'll just go ahead and create a work order for just this one. So we've got all the work order information on here. It's going to be the same as what was on the initial estimate. And then at the end, if you're done, you can go ahead and make a single car invoice. We also support the ability to create multi-car invoices as well if that's needed. So I'll click on Create Invoice, hit the little checkbox. It's going to ask me for a purchase order number. If you don't have it now, you can always enter it in later at any stage. And I'm going to go ahead and save this. So once you're in the invoices section, if you do need to get a signature approval on the invoice, we support that. It's not required, but if it's required by you or your customer, then you can go ahead and do that. And then these could obviously be pulled up, and you could view them on the device if you'd like. You can print them off, you can email them, and so on and so forth. So now that I've created that invoice, let's go about getting this into QuickBooks. For the purposes of today's demo, or this brief demo, we're going to be using QuickBooks Desktop. We support QuickBooks Desktop as well as QuickBooks Online for integration purposes. QuickBooks Online is a little bit easier to work with, we found, just with many of our customers. So if you're on the fence about whether or not you need to use QuickBooks, or you're not sure if you need Desktop or QuickBooks Online, just based on my experience, QuickBooks Online is a little bit easier to work with, just because you don't have to worry about backing up your QuickBooks company file or babysitting the PC that it's on. So what we'll do now is I'll just go to the back office application, which is kind of the management console. So this is where managers would go in. They'd be able to see all the invoices for the day. They'd be able to pull reports. They'd be able to pull commission statements based on their techs. They'd be able to open up the invoice and make any edits if needed. Perhaps a stock number was improperly added in, etc. So all that's possible. What I'll do now is I'm just going to approve this, which is then going to allow us to send it to QuickBooks. So we will help you install this QuickBooks exporter, which is basically the link between your application and your local QuickBooks company file, and it'll allow you to export. So you'll see that this went ahead and exported. Now if I go to the customer center and ABC Ford and open it up, it'll have all of the information from that invoice now within QuickBooks. Many of our clients only use QuickBooks for doing statements and things like that at the end of the month. We do also happen to have a statement report built into our product. So if you don't have QuickBooks, but you do need statements, we definitely have the ability of doing statements as well. So if you're interested, or if you'd like more of a one-on-one tutorial, or if you wanted to sign up, please feel free to reach out and let us know. We'd be more than happy to answer your questions, and we would love to have you as a client. Have a fantastic day.